You are adding more problems to the existing problem.
Not necessarily. If he broke your heart, what kind of problems are you adding to yours?
Thank you very much. Okay. You need to allow yourself to go through that emotional trauma.
So you mean a sense of healing?
Thank you very much. It is normal. God created day and night. We need to sleep at night. If you are sleeping in the day, it means you are trying to cheat nature. But normally, even if you sleep in the day, as soon as night falls, you want to sleep again.
Well, some people want to...
they will come back and sleep.
Well, okay, I get you.
The point is, you need to allow yourself to go through the emotional trauma.
Yeah.
Now, you need to go through the phase where you'll be ordering endless supply of pieces and cupcakes and chocolates and all of that.
I lose weight. I'm like literally,
some people eat a lot.
That's true.
When they are going through that stage.
Now, I eat when I'm happy.
You jump.
Or just for any occasion, just because I like
to. You jump into another relationship immediately after you get out of one. Now, you are running away from a lot of things. You don't want to cry. You don't want to be sober. You don't want to be all alone. Now, you are jumping into the next thing, which is... You want to be attached with somebody who will take away the pain. Now ask yourself, have you even taken your time to study that person that you are going out with?
But I think a lot of times though, I'll throw this to you, Eva, is you actually even want your ex to know that I've moved on.
But you haven't moved on.
Right. But no, you want them to think.
But you haven't.
Okay, Eva.
You are deceiving yourself.
Sometimes is it also a good feeling to know that your ex knows that, Charlie, I've moved on?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it helps him to go and think that, I've really lost someone. Mm-hmm. That I should have been with her because of certain, probably you were too jealous, too immature to even, think about her feelings. Most of the time it's about you, so she has to compromise at
some
point.
Are you speaking from a personal experience? Because I'm feeling, my sister, I am feeling that, I'm feeling you, my sister.
Well, I have a personal experience where the guy is always about me. And you have to compromise. I mean, it's, let's do this, let's do that. You don't get a point to have a say at some point because he really thinks you are supposed to be behind the background and he is supposed to be all over the place and he's a star and everything and all that.
Was he a star?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, he's a star. <isn't it>?
Even if he was, I'm sure you wouldn't reveal him.
No.
So I guess that is also a part of it. So in terms of personal experience, but what happens though when maybe, you've broken up and that person truly doesn't care? Because after you're trying to make it, you're trying to make the person jealous and know you moved on. But a show, because when Nippon is in front of one, a show.
Out of sight, out of mind.
Yeah, you let it go.
You let it go.
And move on.
All right. Now, when you do rebound and jump into a new relationship, I'm thinking of the other person. I think, is it always important for you to disclose everything? Because sometimes, maybe somebody breaks up with someone. They won't tell you, and you're the new man or woman. They won't tell you they just broke up with someone a few weeks.
No.
But then it's still there.
That's one. So when you broke up with your ex, and then you got into a new relationship, did you tell the new guy that I just broke up with someone?
No.
You didn't tell him?
No.
Okay, so by not disclosing everything to him, do you think that was a plus to your new relationship or it was a negative?
It was a plus because then it took away all the whole, and I have to go back and talking about the past and the hurt and everything. So it's a fresh start.
So you just let everything go?
Yeah.
Okay.
That way you are secure that you don't have anything to pick up from there and trying to add in order to help the relationship boost. You go as
it's either the other way around. You pick and add.
That's what I'm actually thinking.
You pick and add.
What I was going to say is, even though you may not tell your new relationship, you still have those
emotions. It's still in there.
So, Steve, what do you make of that? Like, the fact that maybe you're not discussing it, but you're still dealing with
it. It's still in there. The fact that you are in with another guy or in with another girl means you want to prove a point to the person that you just left.
Mm-hmm.
And now, you are with this person, the relationship has already started on a lie. So anybody that does rebounds, I tell those people that they are not disciplined. Because if you are disciplined and you break out of a relationship, you will take your time, go through the phase, and then you jump into another relationship. Meanwhile, you wouldn't do the same mistakes that occurred in the previous one. You correct certain things, and then you have a lasting, lovely relationship. But if you quickly jump onto the next relationship, it means you want to heal quick. You want to fast forward. You see, sometimes human beings want to cheat God. We want to fast forward certain things in life, but we have to go through that
fast
phase.
Action.
You understand? Meanwhile, it is not Fast and Furious 7.
Okay, in terms of that, do you think also that sometimes maybe advice from friends? Because I know most times when we break up with a partner, most people run to a friend to kind of confide it. And sometimes your friend can either give you very good advice or bad advice.
Yeah.
Can friends actually influence you to maybe go the wrong way too quickly? I want to ask you, Eva, when you was friends an impact on your decisions?
Yes, mm-hmm. It was. Because in my previous relationships, some of the guys don't really care much.
Mm-hmm.
They do more of I'm here. They don't attend to you like the way we women want the
True.
Attention, the care, the lavish that. So when one came around, she was like, oh, this one is better, you know, go for him. He's good. And I had to tell her that, no, you know, you have to sit back and then take some time to understand mm-hmm. what this whole thing is about. It's not just about the what he's going to give you, taking you out, mm-hmm. the freebies and all that. Mm-hmm. But at least you have to take your time and look at what he's in for. Maybe he's also coming out from a rebound.
Well,
and you are being the rebound. So,
but if rebound, you rebound together. That's the thing too. I actually know of somebody. There's even a famous story. This rapper, Benny would know. He knows rappers. Something Big 50, Big Sean, who was engaged to this actress in Glee. I don't know her name. They were supposed to get married. The day they were supposed to get married, I think they broke up a month or so before. She married another guy, her ex, on the day of she was supposed to get married, and now she's pregnant. And so far, they seem to be moving on.
I had a friend who dated a girl for a very long time, and then they broke up. The guy was so hurt, he had to come and live with us for 3 good months.
Mm.
Now, he went through the phase.
Wow.
Now, we became like psychologists.
Aww.
We were now giving him therapy, feeding him every day. Mm-hmm. You understand? But after a while, when the girl went, she came back.
Hey.
Yes, she came back to the guy. Because this is it. You go out of a relationship, now you rebound. When you rebound, that person is still in there. Let me tell you people something. Anything that goes into the human mind or the human brain, it never comes out. If you are going to write an exam and you don't remember what you learned, it means you are a lazy thinker. You don't want to go through your brain and think about it. It is always in there.
I don't agree with that. Some of us wrote exams and we forgot. So.
No, but as long as you read it, you should be able to find it somewhere in your brain. So if you are not locating it, it means you are not thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you think about the person, okay, let me share a personal experience.
Okay, that's good.
My first broken heart, which has turned me into the human being that I am today.
Wow.
We broke up on phone, and then I quickly jumped into another relationship. I realized that I was doing that just to get back at the girl. But on the contrary, it wasn't working. Because I was rather hurting myself, because whilst I was with this one, I was rather thinking of the other one. So it was adding more problems to the existing one. Anytime I see her somewhere or even a phone call from her, then my heart starts beating.
You understand? What did that do to the woman you were with at the time?
You were rather hurting her.
Okay.
Because that person is in for good. That person is in for the right reasons. But unfortunately, for now, when you meet somebody, you would find out later that you are going out with, excuse my language, a jackass. Later on, that if you get to know the person more,
but when
you don't know, it's all cozy, it's all nice, it's all lovely. When you are with this person, you are thinking of the other person.
Mm-hmm.
When you see the other person, your heart begins to beat.
Okay.
Now, you haven't still gotten over this person. That person is still a part of you because you guys got together emotionally.
Mm-hmm.
So until this one goes away and you go through that phase, it is still there and it will forever be there. That is why they say, like, Momo Chu of Elihe. It means when you are with a current girl, when you meet your old girlfriend from 10, 15 years ago, you understand? It just like that.
Oh, Okay. Oh, unfortunately, we always run out of time on Heart Bay. I'd love to delve into a little bit more, but I want to thank my two guests. So Eva is definitely saying, you know what? If we break up today and love comes tomorrow, she gonna grab it. But Steve is like, nah, I'm going to wait. So, hey, we'd love to know what you also think. Make sure you send your comments in and to NewDay. All right.